Consists just a quick reminder. Although everyone is tired, I know that everyone is tired, but this is a quick reminder. I was reflecting on the fact that Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned number of times in numerous places in the Quran that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed it as Quran and Arabian. Yes, in Surah Yusuf. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. Also, we read yesterday, subhanAllah, the Imam read in Surah Az-Zumar, وَلَقَدْ ضَرَبْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا غَيْرَ ذِي عِوَجٍ. And on that safha, on that page, Allah Jalla Ala says, الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثاني تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء. سبحان الله. In numerous places Allah Jalla Ala says about this Quran that it is a Quran Arab. My dear brothers and sisters, wallahi, if you learn Arabic and you will listen to the Imam when he recites Quran, you will be living in a different world. You will be living in a different world. And wallahi, from the bottom of my heart, I feel sorry for those who do not understand Arabic. I really feel sorry for them, because they are not enjoying Quran. They just enjoy to the listening of the Quran, but the powerful meanings of the Quran are not there. They just listen, maybe if the Imam has a beautiful recitation, they will enjoy it. If the Imam has no beautiful recitation, they will not enjoy it. But the Quran in of itself is a very enjoyable speech. And once you start listening to it, especially in Salat al-Taraweeh, and you move from one surah to another surah, you are moving from one garden to another garden, you are picking different fruits from different places, you are going through a journey from one subject to another subject, from taqwa to talking about talaq, to talk about what is happening, what will happen in the day of resurrection, what happened to previous nations, from the story of Ibrahim to the story of Lot to the story of Nuh, in a very smooth way, in a very amazing, overwhelming way, that you have no power to stand that. And when you listen, you will just be overtaken by the power of the language of the Quran. Wallahi, my dear brothers. So that's why, from the bottom of my heart, an advice to all of you is to learn Arabic, to know the basic meanings of the Quran in order to enjoy your Islam. Wallahi, those who have weak iman, yes, those who have weak iman, they have weak connection with the Quran. Either they read it, they do not understand it, or they do not read it in the first place. In fact, just by listening to the Quran, yesterday, for example, we listened to Surah Az-Zumar. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز الحكيم إنا أنزلنا إليك الكتاب بالحق فاعبد الله مخلصا له دين. We read also Surah Sad, different nature, as if it is a different speech, but it is the same speech. Sad. والقرآن للذكر بل الذين كفروا في عزة وشقاق. When you read and you understand the basic meanings of Arabic, you just say, Subhanallah, this is a proof that Allah Jalla wa Ala is different from anyone. Wallahi, you will see that, oh, this kalam is so superior. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala is so superior. Allah is the Lord. Allah cannot be compared with any of the created beings. Just by what? By listening to the kalam of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Those words, subhanallah, that when the Imam read, Allahu nazzala ahsan al-hadith, a challenge, subhanallah, power, confidence. Allah revealed the best of his speech. Who can challenge me? Let him come. That's why in the other ayah, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, قُلْ لَئِنْ اجْتَمَعَتُ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Allahu Akbar. Really, it is very powerful speech. It is overwhelming and it is empowering. Anyone who believes in it, anyone who endorses that. Something above imagination. Above imagination. And wallahi, brothers, wallahi, the most eloquent person who can give the best maw'idah, yes, will not reach even to just a tiny level of the maw'idah, of the admonition of the Qur'an. When you read this ayat, Allahu nazzala ahsan al-hadith, kitaban mutashabih, mathani taqsha'irru. Shuf, listen to this. Taqsha'irru minhu juludu alladhina yakhshawna rabbahum, thumma talinu juluduhum wa qulubuhum ila dhikrillah. Yes, the skin will shiver. Those who fear Allah Jalla Ala, their skin will shiver when they what? When they listen to what? Just the kalam of Allah Jalla Ala. Then as a result, the shiver, the skin will what? Will be softened. And most importantly, what? وَقُلُوبُهُمْ. The heart will be softened. That's why many of the Salaf said the statement, if you do not find your heart when you listen to the Quran, you have no heart. You have no heart. خلاص. لا إله إلا الله. Because it is something عجيب. It is something عجيب. That's why, my dear brothers, we can continue talking about it. Learn Arabic, brothers. Learn Arabic, my dear sisters. So you can really enjoy this kalam that is عجيب. And wallahi, wallahi, brothers. Wallahi. If you just in Ramadan, if you listen to the entire Quran, moving from one subject to another subject, talking about politics, talking about economics, talking about sociology, and most importantly, glorifying Allah Jalla wa Ala. Glorifying, exalting Allah Jalla wa Ala. Wallahi, you will be empowered and you will really be a person who is connected to Allah, and you will not believe in any other than the divine value. May Allah Jalla wa Ala give us the barakah of the Quran. And may Allah Jalla wa Ala make us enjoy the beauty of the kalam of Allah Jalla wa Ala, especially in this blessed month. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.